Hello and welcome back to the channel. My name is Drew. This is Just a Guy Linux on YouTube. And today I'm going to be doing an install of Debian Bullseye. Now the goal of this video is to be able to roll back if something goes wrong with our installation or basically our upgrade once Debian Bookworm is out. And in particular, if you are using something that doesn't play well, then the ability to quickly roll back to Debian Bullseye in a stable way is going to be what we are going over today. And I've been learning about this with a number of different content creators on Linux. I've never seen anybody do this on Debian, so this will be kind of new and interesting for me. So I'm going to go ahead and use the Debian net install firmware edition. And excuse me, I'm going to go to the expert install. And choosing my language. I've done this many times. I am going to do some different things today, and I will explain once we get there. Okay. If I'm going through this a little bit quickly, it's because there's nothing very special about what I'm doing right now, and it's easy to follow. For me, I am using a wired connection. So I've had a few people that have asked me about, you know, problems with their wireless. I really haven't had it. In fact, I recently reinstalled my laptop yet again, using GNOME and Debian Bullseye. So, and it's fine. I don't use my laptop that often though. So, configure. But it seems to be working really nicely. Okay, Just a Guy Linux on the host name is good. I'm just going to hit continue again. And then I always do this. I enable shadow passwords, but I disallow this login as root. And the reason why is so that you don't have to go through changing username permissions and all that stuff like that. It just does it for you. So cool. No is the answer here. My name and my password. And I'm going to configure the clock, Eastern time zone, and partition disk. Don't try not to go too fast through this. Excuse me. Because I'm going to go manual here. And I'm going to go down to this SSD. And we're going to create an empty partition using GPT. All right. Now let's arrow down to the free space and we're going to create a partition, and I'm just going to say it can be anything, but I'm just going to use half a gig for the partition size and hit continue. And we're going to go with the beginning and we're going to use this as an EFI system partition. Now if you get a something that pops up on your screen during this process and it says, do you want to force UEFI? If you only want one OS on that machine, then go ahead and say force. So anyway, we are done with this. And we're going to go down one arrow and create the partition with all the rest of the space. And we're going to use it as ButterFS. We're not going to change anything, so we're just going to say done for now. And we're going to finish. And we're not going to do swap yet. So we're going to say, do you want to go return? And the answer is no. So let's write the changes. Do not go fast here because we're going to set this up using command line. And in order to do that, you're going to say Control-Alt-F2. Okay? And now hit Enter. Let's df-h, and we're going to umount target boot EFI. And we're also going to umount the target. Okay. Now, let's ls, and we're going to mount dev sda2 to the mnt directory, and we're going to cd into it. Okay, now ls. So here's where we're going to do something different. I've done this video many times, and or at least part of this, and generally what I'll do is I'll say move at root fs, and I'll usually say at. Now I'm not going to hit enter here, okay? Excuse me. So if I plan to use time shift, I will do this particular command, because time shift looks for this kind of at symbol for root, and it's a lot easier. I'm not going to do this, and I'm not going to be using time shift. And the only reason why is because I actually want to use command line to do my snapshots so that I can pick and choose and at certain times. Anyway, I just thought to myself, this is a little bit different. And I think it's got actually going to lend itself to being able to roll back easier if you follow this methodology. So instead of just saying at root fs and move it to at, I'm just going to simply change it to root. Okay? Now, I'm going to butterfs subvolume create, and I'm also going to create one called home. Okay, now let's ls, and we've got home and root. Now, we are going to mount now our root. So we're going to say mount dash o and rw. So we're going to give it options. RW, no A time, space underscore, underscore, sorry, cache, goodness sake, equals V2, and we're going to compress equals ZSTD. And since this is an SSD drive, we're going to say SSD also, same thing, and same reason, we're saying discard equals async. Now, comma. The subvol is equal to root. And we're going to change this to dev sda2. And we're going to say target. Okay? We are going to do a couple things. We're going to make directory, and same thing. We're going to make target boot. Oop. Boot EFI, and we're going to make directory target and home. Now, let's hit the up arrow key three times, 1, 2, 3, and we're going to change this root to home, and we're gonna obviously going to add the slash home to the end of the line and hit enter. Now, with Debian, you must, I got one more step. So you want to mount dev sda1 to target boot EFI. So we have to add sda1 back. And now we need to change the fs tab, which is something you must do using nano. And it's under target, etsy, fs tab. Okay? Now, we are going to go down to the line with defaults. And we're going to remove defaults and we're going to add back what we the options that we did before, which is RW and no A time, space underscore cache equals V2, compress equals ZSTD, SSD discard equals async. And again, the subvol is, we're going to take out that at symbol and just remove the FS at the end, and we're good to go. Now I'm going to use the home key on my keyboard. You don't have to. I just want to go to the front of the line, first part of the line, and say Control K. Okay, Control K is cut. Control U twice. All right. And we're going to go to the this slash and put in home. And we're going to change root to home on this line. And let's go back. And so we've got everything we need. And let's Control O, enter, Control X. Now, in order to go back to the installation, you must hit Control Alt F1. And so let's resume and hit install. I've done this a few times. This is different though, because, and it'll become clear once we get done with the installation. Okay, we're going to hit enter and enter again. And I kind of lost my train of thought there for a second. Okay, so configure the package manager. And yes, we're going to use the network HTTP US. You can pick anything if you know what your quickest mirror would be. And I'm going to go down to the Atlanta mirrors for me and hit continue. And yes for non-free. And no for enable source repositories. Now I am going to go ahead and add backported software here. This might be a little bit of an overkill based on what we are going to do later, which is to update to Debian Bookworm. So I'm going to go ahead and just go leave it as is and hit continue. And select software, which I won't be selecting any software. And nope. And no again. Now, again, there's nothing wrong with installing anything here. I'm just going to go this for the purposes of this video. I am choosing not to put any desktop environment on this machine. I am going to use the standard utilities and hit continue. You can always add it back later. You know, you can always just do an install. When you use the that method for installing, it's going to install quite a bit of software in addition to the desktop environment. And I would like to choose, that's my personal opinion, I'd like to choose which what software actually gets added. There will be times where I do pause. It's just not yet. So install, grub. Nope. And let's finish. So see right there, I don't know if you saw, it was really quickly, but it installed sudo for you, and you know, it did everything once, because we you know, we selected no for root. That's what happened later on in the installation process. So yes, and continue, and we are good. Now I am going to grab the USB key that did the installation out of that USB slot. And we're going to go to a command line. And there you go. I'm going to log in. And I'm going to sudo dpkg reconfigure console-setup and authenticate, just so that I can get a larger font for the video. And we're going to go and do this, and there you have it. Okay, I'm going to LSBLK here. So we're looking at SDA 1 and 2, and I'm going to use sudo subvolume. Sorry, I need butterfs. Butterfs subvolume list and slash, and you can see those two top level partitions, root and home. Okay, now what we need to do is create a couple folders within for snapshots. Since we're not using time shift, we're going to say sudo mkdir dash p, and we're going to put it in slash dot snapshots, and we're going to call this root. Okay, this obviously for our root subvol, and hit enter. Now let's go ahead and up arrow and just change this to home as well. Okay, now let's create a snapshot. And so in order to do that, we're going to sudo butterfs. Let's go ahead and actually, you know what? Let's clear the screen and say sudo butterfs and subvolume snapshot. And we're going to put this, we're going to take a snapshot of root. So slash. And we're going to put it at slash dot snapshots. And we're going to put it in root. And what are we going to call it? Okay. So let's call it bullseye and minimal, because there's minimal. Because there's nothing in the root subvolume except our minimal installation of bullseye. Okay, I don't know if you want to timestamp it or you want a different descriptor, but that's the way I think I'm going to do it. That way I know it's, you know, you could put it, you could name it anything you want. So, but I know what that means by bullseye minimal. And so I'm going to hit enter. Okay. And it created the snapshot. Let's do an up arrow here. And let's take slash home and also change the root to home. And when I hit enter, it created a home snapshot. Okay, cool. So now if I go up arrow a few times and go back to that butterfs subvolume list command, you'll see that you've still got your subvols at root and home, but you also see the snapshots of bullseye minimal for both your root and your home. So I want to install Qtile. And the reason why is because it'll work on bullseye, but I have a very, very strong feeling that it will not work on Bookworm, at least in its the way I think it will update or upgrade, I should say. The upgrade path will probably break Qtile, at least during the testing. I mean, we're going to obviously have Bookworm or Debian testing and in one of the next steps, but I've never gotten it Qtile to work correctly. Now, I think everything else will. I think, like, if I was to install DK or BSPWM or DWM, I really think the upgrade path would be seamless, you know? But if it's Python based, and I am going to try to fix this, but I really think it's going to fail. It's just the way it is, all right? So let's sudo apt install git and micro and zram tools. And let's start with that, okay? And since we don't actually have a swap, I'm going to do that super quick because I am, say, sudo micro etc default, goodness, zram swap. And I'm simply going to uncomment that line, uncomment the percent, and let's put 25 and say okay. And so I am going to go ahead and git clone two things. One is my https github.com and then my user and Qtile dash Debian. And while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and get my scripts. Okay. But I am going to cd into Qtile Debian ls. Okay. And I am going to, let's look at micro and then install.sh. Okay. And this will work. I'm very confident that this will work within, within Debian Bullseye, okay? So I probably will, once it starts rolling and installing all these packages, I probably will just cut away and come back. But you see what I'm installing if you are not following and you're not doing the installation. It's really unnecessary if you're just looking for the content associated with being able to roll back. And so I am going to comment out a few things. You know what? I actually might. I think my Qtile config uses Tilex, so I am probably just going to use Tilex right here. And micro is already installed, so I don't need that. And I think that should be it. Now, this section, by the way, is kind of nice because it does add Qtile to your the Qtile.desktop file to your X sessions. It's nice. And then let me go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and well, no, I'll do that off camera. That's no big deal. I was going to install the nerd fonts. That's the only other thing I was going to do. Okay, but I won't. I'll do it off camera. So I'm going to Control S and Control Q. And now I'm going to /install sh. So it's off and running. It's going to be doing the installation for, you know, a few minutes. But there's really no reason for you to watch this part. So I will pause. Okay, the install script is done. I did not install my nerd fonts yet. That's fine. I'll do it later. But I will reboot. Okay. Alrighty. Guess that's a good sign. And there you go. Just making sure that Qtile selected. And there you go. Okay. And so this is your default Qtile. You know, I don't know that I was gonna actually I could go ahead and put my configuration of Qtile. I don't think it's relevant, actually. I mean, the fact that it is working is really all that's necessary. So that's fine. You know what? I'm going to pause it. It doesn't matter for video purposes. I will go ahead and put my configuration. It'll only take a few minutes. So I will pause and do my config real quick. Okay, we are back. The configuration that I use is put into place. I think it was only about 2 or 3 minutes to do that from my dot files. And so we're ready to go. What we need to do, though, is create another. I'll just leave it like this. Control L. There we go. We need to create another snapshot. So let's sudo butterfs subvolume. List and slash. And there are those two snapshots that we had before. So we're going to do roughly the same thing. We're going to say sudo butterfs subvolume snapshot, and it's going to be that slash for the root, and then we're going to put it in /.snapshots and root, and we're going to call this one, though, bullseye. And it can be anything, like I said, Qtile, or time, or good, or anything like that. It is good right now, so you could just rename it good. But let's just call it Qtile. I'll know that it's good. You'll know that it's good. We're all good. So we created that snapshot, and we're going to do the same thing for home, and let's go and do home. Now let's go back up a couple, and here we've got snapshots for bullseye minimal and bullseye Qtile, both for root and home, which is great. So let's booger something up. And the way to do that is to basically say sudo micro etsy apt sources list. Okay. Now, in order to update at this point today, before the release, we're going to just put bookworm in here, okay? And we'll put bookworm here. And bookworm here. And as far as the backports are concerned, I'm not sure there is one, so I'm gonna just gonna comment out the, I'm gonna comment out this bullseye backports because it's, I think, irrelevant at this point when you're going all the way up to bookworm. And I'm gonna go ahead and saved and quit. So now when I sudo apt update, you know, it's going to give me hundreds, hundreds of packages, which I will not bore you with. So, but I am going to go sudo apt upgrade and kick it off and say yes. And then I will pause for rebooting into Bookworm. Okay, I am rebooting into Debian Bookworm now. New grub, new kernel. And there's our new light DM. Now, Qtile is still selected. Now, when I log in here, I have a feeling it's going to loop and just go back to this. Now, there you go. So what happens? What do you do if it fails like this and you can't, it's like, okay, well, I can't get to my, I can't get to any type of desktop environment that I can use like time shift. So I guess you can use command line to do that. Now I'm gonna do it a different way. So I'm going to restart and we were gonna go into a live environment, okay? So, oh, I need to hit F12, don't I? Shoot, I missed it. All right, let's do that again. F12. And there you go. And let's go into this Ventoy again, okay? And so it doesn't matter, but I am gonna just go ahead and select this live 11.7 version of Mate. And let's go with that. And there you go. Hopefully it won't take that long to boot. It's a little bit on the heavy side. I think it's actually even heavier than that other live environment that I had on that on this stick, which is Fedora. But I think it'll boot roughly the same time. And maybe not. Maybe not. Give it another second or two before I freak out. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. All right. So we've got a live environment, and I am going to open a terminal. All right. And let's make this bigger. Sure. Colors. Let's go with black on light yellow. That's cool. And there you go. Okay. All right, let's LSBLK. And we're gonna work off this SDA2, okay? SDA2, and we need to mount it, all right? So actually, let's go ahead and become root for this particular part of the for this particular part. And we want to mount the subvolume for SDA2. So we're going to mount it dash O and butterfs. And sorry, it's actually dash T butterfs, and then dash O, and subvol ID equals 5. So these are the top level subvolumes. So this will be both home and root. So, and then we're going to say dub SDA2, and we're going to put that on MNT. Okay. Now we can CD into MNT. And when we do an LS, we see both home and root. Now the current root is actually our Debian bookworm. So this is after the update. And after the update, it didn't work. So we want to go roll back. So let's move root to root bookworm. Okay. Now we've got root bookworm, but what we need to do is add back a root that works. So let's move root bookworm and snapshots. And we're going to take it from the root directory, and we're going to get bullseye, and we could go back to qtile, or we could go back to minimal. So what we're going to do is qtile, okay? And we're going to move it to root. So now when I do an ls, you'll see both home, root, and root hyphen bookworm. And I think what we need to do is reboot, simply. So there was no way to get to, and there you go. There's our grub from Debian Bullseye, and there's the kernel from Debian Bullseye. And now when we log in, we see our Debian Bullseye, excuse me, qtile version. Now, this is probably what I'm going to do I don't know that I would need to do this if I was using something like XFCE or KDE or anything else. Maybe some of the other window managers might have some problems. Probably not. But when you're talking about having an issue with Python, you're having an issue with qtile. That's just the way it is. Okay. So I hope this helps you maybe a little bit. I know that I am doing this for me primarily, but if you find it helpful, please let me know and either like or comment below. So thanks and see you soon.